In 2008, Sony Pictures acquired the movie rights to Peyo's beloved Smurfs. A live-action CG film was released 3 years later, which was followed by a sequel. While there were plans for Smurfs 3, Sony instead opted to make a fully computer-animated film with Kelly Asbury, titled Smurfs: The Lost Village. A more faithful adaptation of Peyo's original comics, I thought the movie was magical, creative, and delightful. The general critical response was on the mixed side, though, as it was seen as just another Smurfs movie. However, I think it's a lot better than it's given credit for. When he signed on to direct the film, Asbury sought to capture the spirit of Peyo's drawings and characters. As a longtime Smurfs fan, I feel he succeeded beautifully, while also creating an entertaining story in the process. When most people think of the Smurfs, they tend to remember the Hanna-Barbera series, and how the episodes mostly depicted the Smurfs as easygoing, always friendly, and always singing. The original Smurfs in the comics were actually more complex in their characterizations and development, and The Lost Village was able to bring those back. The Smurfs had flaws, they did get angry with one another, and they had a variety of emotions, and this is depicted quite nicely in the movie. The decision was also made to make Smurfette the central character and explore her uniqueness within the village. As those familiar with Smurfs mythology know, Smurfette was not a natural-born Smurf, and was instead created by the evil wizard Gargamel to infiltrate the village. This plan, of course, backfired, but the film nonetheless depicts Smurfette questioning her own identity, her role among the Smurfs, and her continued uneasiness with her origin. Her arc throughout the movie comes from searching for the titular village, and proving herself a helpful member of the community. The Smurfs property has been criticized for a long time for just making Smurfette the girl Smurf, and The Lost Village did a good job of responding to this by fleshing her out a bit. Another key decision came from revealing this Lost Village is populated with female Smurfs, each with their own identifiable personalities. We're able to get a sense of how they function in their own society, and the warrior element is a particularly clever idea. The filmmakers and artists made the Lost Village look appropriately different from the Smurfs village we're familiar with, and I also liked many of the characters, including Smurf Storm, the action girl Smurf, appropriately voiced by Michelle Rodriguez, and especially Smurf Blossom, a hilarious hyper Smurf with the voice of Ellie Kemper. Smurfette is joined by Clumsy, Hefty, and Brainy, and the movie shows the conflicts that arise with pairing these Smurfs together. There are some sweet scenes of the four of them happily talking together. However, like I said before, these are not the always cheerful Smurfs people assume they are. We see how Brainy's know-it-all attitude and Hefty's macho personality contrast and create a rift. The main villain is, unsurprisingly, Gargamel, and I thought the filmmakers made great use of him here. Some of the biggest laugh-out-loud moments for me come from Gargamel's antics and his continuous attempts to catch the Smurfs. Rainn Wilson's vocal performance adds a lot too, and he really disappeared into the role. There's not a single ounce of Dwight Schrute in Gargamel. Gargamel's pets provide their own delights too, with the animators doing a particularly good job of capturing Azrael's impatience with him. There was disappointment from Smurf fans over the decision to have Gargamel extract the Smurf's magical essence rather than eating them, but I don't see a problem with this. He still wants to capture the Smurfs out of some personal gain, and there is a desire to not see him become the most powerful wizard in the land. Another element changed from the source material is the lack of replacing words with Smurf. This was a major component of the comics, as well as the television series and live-action movies. Some funny and clever scenarios have come about based on the Smurfs inserting the word Smurf into their vocabulary multiple times. However, I can also understand why Kelly Asbury would want to move away from this, as it can get tiring hearing it for an entire feature film. Now I want to talk about the world of the movie. Peyo created an entire magical realm in the comics, and the artists at Sony Pictures Animation followed suit by packing the movie full of amazing creatures. The level of imagination on display is incredible, including rabbits who glow in the dark, devilish piranhas, and Venus flytraps that try to gobble up our Smurf heroes. I also have to praise Noel Trillo's production design, which is quite striking and faithfully recreates Peyo's drawing style. The use of shape and color is magnificent and really helps bring this world to life on the big screen. Patrick Matey also did a superb job with his character designs, which look exactly like the personalities from the original comics. I think the simplicity of the Smurfs' designs really lends itself to computer animation. The animation in The Lost Village is appropriately vibrant, bouncy, and full of energy. I know some online circles have taken aim at the character animation in Sony's films for emphasizing cartoony movements and expressions, but I don't see the problem. I love how most of the Sony Pictures animation productions look like cartoons, but converted to a three-dimensional world. Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs, Hotel Transylvania, and Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse are all gorgeous-looking movies in my opinion, and all are visual treats for the eyeballs. I've long admired the studio's willingness to push what computer animation can do and that constant experimentation. Smurfs The Lost Village is just one example of this tradition they have fostered for themselves, and their next film, Connected, appears to be following suit. After all, animation can look like anything. Isn't that the entire appeal of the art form? One criticism I do have towards the movie is the use of pop songs on the soundtrack. A lot of them just felt distracting and took me out of the movie. Eiffel 65's Blue was even included in a montage. Yeah, that was a little on the nose. Christopher Leonard's score was lovely, though, and brought the needed adventurous quality to the Smurfs' journey. To conclude, Smurfs The Lost Village was definitely everything I hoped it would be, and I was smiling through the entire runtime. I even found myself laughing through the end credits at a hilarious meta-gag involving Gargamel. It's an example of why I not only have a fondness for the Smurfs, but also animation in general, as we see an imaginative environment, endearing characters, perfectly executed comedic gags, and heartfelt moments. It succeeded in fleshing out Smurfette and honoring the incredible legacy of Peyo's comics. And it's yet another example of the amazing creativity coming out of Sony Pictures Animation and the theme of community that ran through every film Kelly Asbury directed. Everyone has happy films that brighten their day, and Smurfs The Lost Village is one of those for me. See you next time.